Back to Aimee and Shawn on 102.7 VGS.
So Shawn and I were just talking about Larsa Pippen, who is dating Michael Jordan's son, Marcus. I think they're like 20. No, I don't even think they're 20 years difference. And really, the age isn't what is annoying everybody. It's that Scottie Pippen is her ex-husband and the father of her children. And he and Michael Jordan played together their whole careers.
It's not that there's bad blood there, but there's not a great blood
Well,
there.
Scottie doesn't like him too much, yeah. I don't think. I believe that he said it, and Jordan has come out and said, I wouldn't have won if Scottie wasn't on my team, best teammate ever. But then Scottie has said Michael Jordan was the worst teammate ever. So, like, very controversial.
Imagine, if you feel that way, you're like, all right, I would like to just not be, you know, near that person anymore. But then you hear about, hey, my ex is now dating his son.
Gosh.
Good God.
It's so weird. And I kind of have something a little like it. But not really. So when I met my husband, I met him in 2006. And he had just moved here from California. And I had just moved here from New York. And we met. And we were together for about a year and a half, on and off. Got pregnant with Jaden, and then we're together for 8 years before before we decided to get married. But in those 8 years or 10 years total that we were together, his ex-girlfriend that he had just split up from or with in California had gotten with one of his best friends, and they ended up getting married before Patrick and I got married. And I remember his friend had called him and said, hey, I'm dating so-and-so. Like, you cool with that? And I was like, you better say you're cool with that. Of course you're cool with that. Why would you not be cool with that? So there was no, like, bad blood or anything. But I kind of always felt the type of way. It's a little weird, right? It's a little weird.
It's a little weird. Is it still like his best friend or one of his best? Or,
yeah.
And he's still, okay, that's fine.
Like, we vacationed together.
Oh my God. Wait, you vacation with him and his ex-girlfriend?
Yeah.
Oh, that is so interesting.
They've stayed at our house with their kids. Our kids play. It's so crazy. But
never in the back of your mind.
It's like, that's now.
But never in the back of your mind, even now, you're like, you and you at one point.
Yeah, you know me, of course. I'm like, But
what does she have that I don't? Nothing. That's why I'm with you. Stop. Why are you doing
Exactly. He's always on the stand. Always on the stand.
Poor guy.
He's like, can I say objection, Your Honor? And I'm like, no, you're the witness. So anyways, when we sent the invites out, they had just gotten together. I don't know. I believe she was maybe pregnant, or not just gotten together, just gotten married. And we had to, like, put them on the guest list. And I get along with her so well. Like, she's so awesome, and we're friends. But it was still, at the end of the day, somebody at my wedding had been with my husband. You know what I mean? And it's just, like, so awkward to even think about. But then if you don't think about it, it's just normal because we're friends.
Yeah.
But it's still a little Larsa and Marcus.
Yeah, it's a little bit. It's a little strange. I mean, has he ever met anyone you've been with?
No.
Really?
Yeah, well, because he's never been to my hometown, and I moved here and met him.
Are you keeping him away from the hometown for a reason?
No. I haven't been back since 2007.
You really hate it. You hated it there.
No, I didn't hate it there. Nobody's there anymore. Everybody has moved.
There's, like,
so whenever
one
I go,
friend, pretty much. Or
and
couple,
she had just moved back,
gotcha,
like a few years ago. So, like, there was just never any reason. My grandparents moved away. All my aunts are moved. Not all my friends. There was no reason to go back. But now we're all going back on in July for my reunion.
So you're going to go back for the reunion. I'm assuming that someone's going to be there that you may have been with.
Yeah.
Are you going to tell him?
No.
I've been with this person.
For sure, no.
Okay. So, like, now, there's two frames of mind here. If you tell him, some will say that you're trying to make him jealous.
Facts.
But if you don't tell him, why wouldn't you tell me? It's really a no-win situation.
Well, if he asks, if he says, hey.
So, like, the entire day.
Point out
to do
to
with him. How about him?
Point to me.
If you say yes a lot.
I mean, he knows. Yes. I don't remember.
The teacher?
I think that.
That's what you should do. Just say yes to everyone. Just right. To see his jaw drop.
And I guess also it depends on what they look like 20 years later. If I say yes or not. But in all honesty, I don't think he cares. I mean, it's been so long, right? It's been 20 years. But on the other hand, he knows like the names of my exes. So he knows their names. So if he is introduced to one, like he will know. Right?
Will he give any like, oh, hey, yeah. Ah, Mike. Yep. Heard a lot about you, Mike. How are you, pal?
I don't think so. But it'll be very interesting.
It does. It can get a little awkward. But, you know, listen, that is such as life.
Yeah.
You know, you guys met. You had to date other people beforehand.
Right.
Yeah.
Right.
The people, I know some people that, like, first girlfriend, first boyfriend, they got married.
Mm-hmm.
That is so weird.
It's so cool, though, also.
It's cool. Yeah. It's great. Like, they didn't have to go through any of the trouble. They found their soulmate. Amen. But it's very strange.
Yeah.
Because that doesn't happen very often. Like, you know, the miracle in your brain. You think, like, if I had that, I Debbie Philidoro in fourth grade, I told her I wanted to marry her at Disney World. Yeah. Imagine if I did.
Right.
And all the misery that followed didn't occur.
Yeah.
I could have been so much more successful.
And you know what's so crazy? It's like my mom and dad were high school sweethearts.
Wow.
Yeah. And they've been married 40 years now,
God
almost.
Bless. That's great.
Yeah. So, I mean, I don't know. It'll be very interesting. It'll be very interesting come July.
Does he know your number?
I think so, yeah.
Okay.
But that's the thing. I want to know, but I don't want to know. And he doesn't want me to know because he knows I'm crazy.
Well, you don't know his number?
Yeah. I mean, I'm sure he told me when we first met, but thank God I forgot.
Here's the rule with numbers, all right? Well, like, I don't know, maybe after a certain age, but especially when you're, like, younger, especially in your 20s, whatever the girl says, it's probably, 40% higher than that. And whatever the guy says, it's about
lower.
three times less than that. Peacocking, as it were.
Yes, that's true.
All right, I cannot wait for this reunion. When is reunion again?
The last weekend in July.
Oh, man. Popcorn will be popped. I need full report.